One of the most common questions I get when making a video about a board or a chip is, can it run AI in some form of variation? Today, I want to answer this question once and for all. Yes, it can. Yes, of course. Yep. Absolutely yes. Surprisingly, yes. Okay, funny man, you wanna say. I know I cannot run AI on punch cards. That would be terribly inefficient. That is the point. Let's do a quick breakdown of specific types of hardware and how suitable they are for running AI. First, let's talk about generic compute chips. These can run arbitrary computations. Whatever you can program, they can run. Show pictures, play music, render 3D models. AI is also computation. It's all about crunching zeros and ones in the end. So it can be done on generic compute chips. With a caveat, there are two large categories of generic compute chips, MCUs and MPUs. The dividing line is becoming a bit blurry lately. In general, MCUs are less powerful, they run bare metal firmware or a lightweight OS like FreeRTOS, and they have reduced instruction set. The examples include Raspberry Pi RP2040, NRP2350, ESP32, NRF52840, and so on. MPUs, on the other hand, are more powerful, capable of running one of the three big OSs, and typically have slightly different instruction sets. The examples include Broadcom BCM2712, Apple M1, and AMD Ryzen 7800. Those are the general rules. Of course, there are exceptions. Please write some of them in the comments below the video. The good news is that both MCUs and MPUs are suitable for running any sort of AI. Image, sound, language, you name it. For MCUs, you normally will be severely limited in terms of program space and memory, so you won't be able to run some of the larger models. Even if you could, low clock speed and limited optimizations mean that it would take forever to actually get the response. The solution is to drastically shrink the neural network models. So you can still run image recognition, object detection, keyword spotting, and even smaller language models on MCUs. You just have to accept they won't be as capable as larger models. But they still can fit your use case, and that is what's truly important. Similar idea for MPUs or microprocessors. Raspberry Pi can run AI. You don't need a fancy AI head for that. However, since the microprocessor on board of Raspberry Pi is suitable for generic compute, it loses out on some of the optimizations of the specialized chips. You can run more capable models on MPUs, even being able to work with some of the smaller large language models. But ultimately, you're still quite limited, in this case, by speed of the computation, as program size and memory on MPUs can be easily scaled. Specialized compute is another realm. As you can get from the name, these chips cannot do everything. GPUs were originally made for processing graphics. Unlike MPUs, which focus on single-threaded performance and complex logic execution, GPUs are optimized for thousands of simple, parallel computations at once. Incidentally, this is what deep learning, the backbone of modern AI, is about. GPUs are really useful for training, but also for inference. NVIDIA graphics chips were the best supported from when people started using them for accelerating deep learning. Nowadays, you can also utilize other chips for both accelerated inference and sometimes training. Major machine learning frameworks such as TensorFlow, JAX, PyTorch have added the support for Apple MPS, AMD ROCm, and even Intel GPUs. But beware, not all the devices with GPUs can use the GPU for accelerating AI. The most well-known example is Raspberry Pi, which A, has poor to non-software support for machine learning inference on GPU. B, even if it was possible, the performance is pretty low compared to Pi CPU. In general, GPUs on embedded systems are not great for machine learning tasks, And this brings us to all sorts of NPUs, TPUs, and other buzzworthy abbreviations. These are ASICs, or application-specific integrated circuits. In a complete opposite to MCU, MPU, ASICs are really good for a very specific set of operations, but they are really efficient at them, meaning low power consumption and high speed. The downside is that ASICs are very rigid in terms of mathematical operations they support. So when running machine learning workloads on them, you will run into all sorts of limitations in terms of types of networks. For example, recently launched Raspberry Pi AI head with Halo chip on it is good for machine vision tasks such as image recognition and object detection, but it is not useful at all for transformers type of neural networks, which is what most of current language models are. Support for Whisper speech-to-text model, which is also a transformer, is up in the air for Halo 8L, according to their forum. Language model inference acceleration is a really hot topic now, and I will come back to it in a bit at the end of the video. This video would not be complete without mentioning FPGAs, or field programmable gated arrays. They are a unique type of hardware that is between general purpose processors and ASICs. FPGAs can be reconfigured after manufacturing. This means that you can design custom circuits optimized for specific workloads, including accelerating AI inference. FPGAs can be very power efficient and fast for AI inference because they allow for parallel processing similar to GPUs. The downside, programming them is hard. Using an FPGA for AI often requires knowledge of hardware description languages like Verilog or VHDL, as well as deep optimization skills. In short, FPGAs can run AI and they can do it efficiently, but unless you have a really good reason to use one, you're probably better off with other options. I will be making another video on chips that are actually useful for running language models on them. Subscribe and stay tuned for that.